Now this seems like some kind of punishment, but no, it's not a punishment. You're also helping the child work on the pencil grip. You're also helping to sharpen the fine motor skill of that child. Hello again and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Nonye and I'm a Nigerian teacher. I live and work in Lagos, Nigeria. If it's your first time here, let me be the first to say welcome to this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, I'm super excited to have you come join me again for an interesting video. So if you're new here and you're not subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? The subscribe button is down there. Please click on the subscribe button, tap on the notification bell. That way you'll be the first to know when I drop my new videos. So this video is the second part of the first video that I did in a series of my tips and tricks. Like I explained in the first video that we're working now as parents with our children because they're not getting into school and the teachers are not with them. So I've decided to share some of the tips and the tricks that we use as teachers in schools to help pass information to these children or pass instruction to these children or help them learn. That's what I'm doing in this video. So that's just the background to what I've been doing. So if you've not watched that video, I'm going to link that up in the card so they can watch that after you've watched this one. Doesn't matter if you watch this first and then watch that one later. So very quickly, my next tip is to please always channel your child's energy positively. Can I say that again? Always ensure that you channel your child's energy positively. Okay, some parents have reached out to say that the children are sometimes all over the place and they don't know what to do at some point. Some of them are running around and you've tried to use different instructions to help them to stay in a place or to sit in a place, especially if you live in this part of the world and there's nothing you want to use at that moment to engage them. I'd like to say, why not channel their energy positively? If the child, depending on the age of the child, is running around, you have to think now as parents of an activity that the child can do to help. I give an example of a 4-year or a 5-year-old. You can say, okay, go around the house, count all the chairs, and then count the tables, count. By the time the child has gone round to count, and then you say, oh, I'm sure you didn't go around the house. Now, can you try this one more time? Now you're channeling the child's energy positively. So the child is also counting and then expending energy. So you have to think of activities that you can use to always channel their energies positively. There's another example that I saw of a parent who gave the child a bowl of bean seeds, or you can use cereals. She told the child to count, and that when the child is done counting, the child should come and knock at her door to say, okay, I'm done counting. So that's like channeling the child's energy positively. Now this seems like some kind of punishment, but no, it's not a punishment. You're also helping the child work on the pencil grip. You're also helping to sharpen the fine motor skill of that child. So the child is also learning while you're channeling the energy positively. I hope this makes sense to you. If it does, give this video a thumb up. My second tip for this video is to study how your child learns so that you can teach your child how the child can learn. I don't know if you understand this, but let me break it down. You have to learn your child's style of learning so that when you want to teach, you're going to use the child's style of learning to teach that child. I've seen some children who are very musically inclined. It means that if you have to teach them the concept of numeracy, you have to apply music, right? So you've studied how this child learns so that you can help the child learn because you have taken your time to study. Now, some theorists came up with these intelligences in children, and these intelligences is what teachers are currently using now to help every learner learn. Teachers have been taught to study individual child to understand how they learn particular concept, and then always bring in their style of learning to these children so that these children can learn using their own style of learning. So you see that that's a lot of work for teachers to do, and that's why I'm sharing this as a tip and trick for you. So why not just learn how your own child learns? So if you're helping the child to do some activities or some tasks, especially now that they're having tasks to do online, then you may have to get how your child would understand this concept and then use that pattern to help the child. If the child is also numeracy inclined, for example, and you want to teach literacy or creative writing, for example, instead of just asking the child to write, why not just bring concepts of mathematics? Like, for example, use stories that has to do with going to the market or shopping or buying and adding and subtracting, so that when the child is writing, the child bring in concepts of mathematics like addition and subtraction. I went to the store, I bought these for a certain amount, and then I subtracted, and when I got my change, the exact amount of money was, you know, just make sure that you use this style and this concept to help your child learn a particular concept. It means that you have to take your time to study how that child learns so that you can teach or guide that child to learn how he or she learns. I hope this makes sense to you. So these are my two tips for today's episode of Tips and Tricks. Like I said earlier, if this video makes sense to you, please give it a thumb up. That's where more people can get to watch it. You can share it, you're free to share it. Subscribe to this channel, click on the notification bell if you've not done that. And let me know in the comment section what you think about these tips and tricks. Thank you so much for watching until I come your way, God willing, in another video. It's bye for now.
If you're new to my channel, click on the subscribe button, tap on the notification bell, like it, comment, and share. Thank you.